Hello everyone and welcome to Ace Studios. Today I'm going to be explaining four more tattoo styles by drawing them as flowers. These styles are subcategories of the original styles that I touched on in my first video on this subject. There are of course many more styles than just these, I just didn't have a lot of time to make this video. So you have any other styles that you want me to draw flowers in, let me know down in the comments. This first style is something that I call girly traditional. This style can be in blackwork and color, but this style is particularly in blackwork now because it is inspired by an artist that I follow on Instagram, as you can see up on the screen now, Carolyn Derwent. This style is of course a subcategory of traditional. That's why it's girly traditional in the title. And of course, it has the big, bold, black lines that traditional has, and is very depictive in its imagery. Of course, it's not illustrative like neo-traditional, but it is very beautiful in its own right. Girly traditional tends to have very round shapes and soft edges, even though the line work is very bold. These can stay as just line work or they can be shaded in the way that Carolyn does it. It is skit shading and I'm trying to emulate that by using my pen to draw quickly across the paper. Now, I can't get the skit shading perfectly because I'm not jabbing a needle into skin and I'm using a pen, but I try my best to imitate the way that skit shading looks on skin. I really enjoyed making this flower, even though it was a lot quicker than I would usually do because I choose to do more illustrative style, I thought it was really fun to experiment. The next style that I'm going to go over is girly traditional but in color, which has very different ways of shading and coloring. I put a few examples on the screen, one of which is a dot coloring technique, which is called glitter coloring, and just a kawaii tattoo that I found as inspiration. Carolyn also does this style of tattooing because simply it is a different way of coloring. But I wanted to go elsewhere to find a little bit of inspiration. A few ways that you would recognize girly traditional in color is the sparkle or glitter effect, which is basically a bunch of dots that make it look like it's glitter on the skin. When done successfully, it does in fact look like glitter. I didn't capture it completely well in my rendition of this flower, but I think you get the point. Also, another big thing that is in girly traditional that is in color is a lot of hearts and bold shapes. Lace work is also something that you may find in this style. I decided to go with a heart with a flower in it because it is something that I see a lot in this style, and I thought that I would be able to take this style and make it my own with this piece. I decided to use markers to color this one because I thought it would be the easiest way to get those dots the way that I wanted them to be. Even though I wasn't the most successful in creating the illusion of glitter, I think it still looks very nice in the way that it is colored. I, of course, also don't draw in this style, so I tried my best to imitate what people like Carolyn would do to create this style. But these bold and bright tattoos aren't the only ones that you will find across Instagram. You'll also find some rather controversial tattoos. And not necessarily controversial in the imagery of the tattoo itself, but the way that it is put into the skin. Here is an image of a kind of tattoo that I am talking about, and these are usually called thin line or one needle tattoos. The reason that they are so controversial is because usually they are very small, very detailed, and don't last. A lot of people who aren't interested or into the industry of tattooing and how it works will want to get a tattoo, but they want it super tiny so that no one can actually see it. This is almost the exact opposite of what I just talked about with the girly traditional and traditional in general. These tattoos tend to be very small, very delicate, and very feminine, even though I just showed you that traditional can be feminine as well. So one of the most common things that are drawn in this style are lavender sprigs, so I decided to go ahead and draw lavender sprigs as well. In this, I chose to use a black outline, which is not very common when you think of lavender spring tattoos, but I decided to do that anyway because it's something that I like to do. Though, as you saw in my inspirational reference photo, a lot of these tattoos are just black lines. I would suggest against getting these types of tattoos because even if you only want something once and only want something delicate, they're bound to not last as long as if you get something bolder or bigger. After all, if you don't want people seeing your tattoo, don't get a tattoo. And if you really want a tattoo that's temporary like these, get henna or get one of those tattoos that you get at your local fairgrounds. Although these are pretty, they're not necessarily the best kind and longest lasting of tattoos. Which some may also say about this next style of tattooing that I will be showing you today, and that is watercolor tattooing. I follow a wonderful tattoo artist, Nathan, who works in Chicago and does absolutely wonderful watercolor pieces. Some people think because there are no black in these designs that they won't stay as long, which may be true in some cases, but other times they are very well executed. I am sorry for the strange camera angle here. I was working on this at work and I was using my phone camera instead of my actual camera. I had the first three already done and then I was like, wait, I want to do watercolor because in my previous video I had done a watercolor piece and it just didn't turn out as well. This time I was determined to get something good, so I drew inspiration from the piece that I showed you that Nathan had done, and I decided to incorporate that kind of work into my own. I am actually doing this with watercolors, and a lot of watercolor tattoo artists do actually paint their pieces in watercolor before they are tattooed. I think that's a great way to not only keep up your artistic ability on paper, but also design something that's worthy of skin. I first start out with the bolder lines and then move on to the actual background of the watercolor painting. My favorite part about watercolor tattooing is that it's so fun and so colorful, and I absolutely love painting in watercolor, and I hope that one day I'll be able to do my own watercolor tattoos on other people. This one took the longest for me to make, so I'm going to go quiet while you guys watch me work on this piece, which I absolutely love the ending result of. Alright, everyone, that's all I have for you today. I hope you enjoyed my rendition of Tattoo Styles as Flowers Part 2. Thanks for bearing with me and my schedule while I'm at school. Some videos may be posted late or not at all. Just make sure to keep up with me on Instagram and I will try my best to get out a video every week. Thank you guys so much for watching and hopefully I will see you next week.